don't know. Go ahead, Kathy.
Okay, thank you. Our mission, Helping Parents Heal, is a nonprofit organization dedicated to assisting bereaved parents. Through support and resources offered, we aspire to help individuals become shining light parents, meaning a shift from a state of emotional heaviness to one of hopefulness and a greater peace of mind. Helping Parents Heal goes a step beyond other groups by allowing the open discussion of spiritual experiences and afterlife evidence in a non-dogmatic way. Helping Parents Heal affiliate groups welcome everyone, regardless of religious or non-religious background, and encourage open dialogue. Attendance at all Helping Parents Heal meetings is voluntary. All discussions that take place at affiliate-led meetings are confidential. We hope that participants will learn from and share with each other. Zoom meetings run by Helping Parents Heal leadership are not confidential. These meetings typically feature guest presenters and are posted on YouTube so that affiliate members worldwide can watch and benefit. Neither type of Helping Parents Heal meeting is designed to replace traditional therapy or spiritual counseling. Helping Parents Heal offers a wide variety of speakers, allowing parents to learn about the many possible ways to heal. This includes presenters covering progressive topics such as afterlife evidence and connecting with children who have passed. The views expressed by our guest speakers may or may not reflect the opinions of Helping Parents Heal leaders and members, so we ask that you take from their presentations whatever may benefit you personally.
Thank you so much, Kathy. And again, we are thrilled to have Drew here. Again, it's really going to be wonderful to have him at the conference with us as well. And I'm going to go ahead and read his bio, which is shorter. It's a new bio, so everyone listen carefully. Drew Polifrone is known for his expertise as an evidential medium, channel, and intuitive development teacher. He is dedicated to creating a safe and sacred space for the most impactful and soulful dedication to your healing, spiritual expansion, and higher needs. Drew's profound connection to the spiritual realm emerged following significant personal losses and transformative experiences. These events catalyzed his journey to serve as a conduit between the earthly plane and beyond. Drew's commitment to honing his craft led him to pursue extensive training, development, and education. This included immersive courses and mentorship under globally recognized mentors, along with enrollment at the esteemed Arthur Findlay College for Mediumship and Psychic Sciences in the UK. The offerings available at mediumdrew.com are anchored in truth, discovery, healing, and real-life applications. And you can reach Drew at www.mediumdrew.com, which is going to be launched very soon. And without further ado, please join me in welcoming Drew Calley, one of my favorite people. I'm just so excited to have you here tonight. Welcome, Drew.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Elizabeth. And thank you, Kathy, for helping. And thanks for all of you for being here. And it's always an honor to share this space. It always is. Can everyone hear me okay with this? Okay. I had like clicking in my headphones, so I wasn't sure. So one thing I would say is I never, if you knew me 15, 20 years ago, we'd both laugh that I do this. You know, it's like kind of ironic, and at the same time it feels like I was always meant to do it. It's very bizarre. And I am switching from the name Drew Calley. There was a bit of a copyright issue and some other things that were lingering. So Calley was the name of, so the first experience I ever had with a spirit guide was with a gentleman with the name of Great Bear. And he was with Native American, wearing this giant headdress. And I remember just knowing that his name was Great Bear. And then like a couple of years later, I didn't have a name because I owned a different business, and these experiences kept coming. And I was studying and kind of trying to understand, am I supposed to do this? I felt like I was, but I wasn't exactly sure where I was going to go. So in short, I woke up in the middle of the night. I was praying on it for a couple of weeks. What name do I use? Do I use a different LLC? Like, what do I use? And I woke up here and like going back to Cali. Cali, right? That's not why I used it. So don't get ahead of yourself yet. So that would be really bad if I did that. But so I look up the name Cali, and I knew it was with a C. And it was the constellation previously known as Great Bear. And I was like, oh, that's so weird. And it was like, I happened to wake up, it was 2:22, and I type in drewcalley.com and it wasn't taken. So, and it kind of became that from there. And it was like Italian, it fit, right? But my real last name is Polifrone. And not only is it too easy to spell, no. I never really thought about changing it until I had to change it. But I will say, I just go by Medium Drew or just Drew. And when I do this, it always changes, just like we do. You know, I used to think that if you were a medium or a psychic, it's like you would know things, but you were only sharing wisdom with me in bits and pieces, you know, or like almost like, I don't know. I really thought it would be like a ghost standing there talking to me and I wouldn't get anything wrong. But it's really the best explanation that I can kind of give terms to with respect to this is it's almost like experiencing your spirit in first and third person. So it's like a blending and a merging. And what starts to happen is I understand things, I'll hear, I'll see, I'll feel, but it's not so much that they're saying, although I'm understanding. I could know someone spoke Russian, but not know the words that they're using, but still know what they meant. You know, so it's always comes back to an intelligence much greater than me, you know? And I always feel honored to kind of do this. And I'm always in awe of it. You know, I'm always surprised by it. And I think that's a good feeling. So in short, I wasn't always such a good kid. I was trying to escape a lot and run from the house I was in, the house I was brought up in. And eventually I turned to drugs and alcohol. And in my 20s, even though I made a lot of money, I was still drinking and drugging quite heavily. And then I joined the army after 9/11. When I came back, I got a little bit hurt over there. I came back and I got even more addicted to painkillers and alcohol. And then I had a stillborn baby girl at 8 months and 1 week. And 26 days later, my brother-in-law took his own life by a very violent way. And my mom had just passed the year before. My mom was the type of mom that all three of us kids thought we were her favorite, you know? And I was brought up Irish and Italian. So we had traditionally, it would be like considered Catholic, but I don't consider myself religious. And the reason I share all that is because that led me to what really changed everything was when I got sober. I got clean and sober. I stopped altering my mood and my mind. And when I started doing that about a year into it, almost to the day, the sensitivity was so heightened that my sister was like, hey, you got to talk to the psychic. And I remember joking around like, yeah, no, thanks. And I did. And she was pretty good. And she was like, you're going to do this work. And I'll never forget like looking at her, like I curse like a truck driver. I don't have a bath phone to God. My life's not easy. You know, I'm like, what the hell is she talking about? And I'm like, work. I'm like, I already work. What are you talking about? She's like, you're going to do this work. And she's like, just meditate tonight. I mean, I'll remember to the detail of what I was staring at out this bay window. And she was like, she just said like, not only are you going to do this work, but I didn't believe her. And she was like, are you sitting near a fireplace with a brown dog? And I was like, oh yeah, freaked me out. and then she got something wrong. And I was like, see, this isn't real. So she told me I needed to meditate that night to meet my spirit guides. And I was such a smart ass. I was like, spirit guides. I'm like, I don't see them, you know? And that's when she was like, you know, are you sitting next to a fireplace with a brown dog? And I was like, yeah, that's creepy. So I meditated that night. And everything began, you know, I experienced something in a way that I couldn't explain and it kept validating itself over and over. And the next morning I woke up, I turned on the sink and I heard every time I put my hand on the water, I heard, this is Jonathan, you got to call Jason. And I got a picture of Jason. So short of the long, as I ended up going to this guy's house that I didn't really know, picked a picture out of in a book and it started happening in real time, where I could tell like a finger touched my kidney. I knew there was kidney cancer. It was very bizarre. And since then, I always joke, like that was probably the best reading I ever did. And I knew nothing, but it felt very natural. It was almost like it was coming in form of a waterfall. And I was perplexed as to why some days after that, it was like catching a waterfall with a shot glass. You know, like why couldn't I get everything that you wanted, when you wanted it, how you wanted it, exactly as I thought you should receive it. And the more that I studied this, the more that I had to develop me. And in the development of me, the side effect was a clearer connection to spirit. And that seems to be the ongoing theme. You know, I spent 20 some odd weeks at Arthur Findlay College on and off over a 5-year period. I did mentorship after mentorship. I did readings, and I had a good amount of money from a business I owned that I immersed myself, and I read hundreds of books. I became extremely, probably overeducated on certain subjects, but I was still perplexed as to why they weren't working like that for me. And I really got into healing, meditation, trance, and like the healing seemed to really speak to me. And that also altered my mediumship. And although my mediumship is my first love, the awareness of energy and the healing component within it is the most important. You know, if it doesn't help or it doesn't heal, in my opinion, in my experiences, is probably not real. You know, I had somebody who is listening right now, actually, who's on one of my courses and a really, really up and coming medium, really good. And she went to a place locally, and, you know, people will tell you funny stuff. They'll be like, listen, I know everything about you and your future, but I can't tell you. No, like things like that always made me go, I don't know if I want to do this. Like, is this what I want to do? But then I started to meet other mediums that were lawyers, you know, doctors, regular people, and analytical people. You didn't have to be like, I really didn't know who I was when it started happening, because I was just getting like sober and getting to peel the layers back to me. But I really didn't know. I'm like, should I walk around in like a tie-dye shirt, or do I head shaved and live at home? Like, I didn't want to be some weirdo, and I really didn't know how to go about it. And I remember about 2.5-3 years into my development, I had a tutor pull me aside, and I was so over emphasizing technique, because I wanted to get the name, what they looked like, how they passed, and all the details and all the facts. And, you know, I wasn't really feeling, I was seeing and hearing things. So it could be very one-dimensional or dry. And my tutor turned around to me and just said, Drew, I need you to come back to the why. Why are you doing this? Why are you here? Why is spirit allowing this to happen? And why is that person, why is the connection happening? And what I came to also understand was, these are just abilities. Like, I am not special in any way, shape, or form, no more special than any of you. Everyone has access to these to some degree. I came to understand that, you know, the power of the gift is in sharing them with other people. When I share them with other people, they become gifts. It's really interesting. And it doesn't work for me to sit around and talk to my mom or, you know, people in my family, although I might be aware of them and know the signs and the symbols, but it's a totally different language I had to learn. And if I'm emotionally too invested, it seems to be in the way. So I don't read for people I know and I love too often, because I want for them, and I am attached to the outcome that I think they want. And I really need to be objective and kind of touch the needs. And that's really been my experience in a nutshell. A lot of things people told me early on, I was like, let me go try it anyway. You know, it's like, you're telling me the stove's hot. I'm like, let me just put my face on it. Hang on a sec. And I just kept relearning these things over and over. And also I learned that there's a lot of really good mediums with a lot of different takes on this and a lot of different personalities. But one thing that seems to be agreed upon, and I've studied the best, learned from the best, pursued the best, read about the best, had lunch with the best. I was obsessed with really understanding, like, what am I missing? And we all agree that we don't know a lot more than we know, you know? And I love when it starts to blend science and spirit, you know, but I also am very careful not to draw conclusions. I always joke, like, I've done readings for people where I thought a brother and a sister was a husband and wife. So the conclusion in my mind changed the narrative of the way that I connected. So we have to be standing in the river, drinking, filling up our cups and drinking from it at the same time, that river of life, that river of consciousness, that river of eternity. And I can't bottle up your person and run down the street and give them to you the same way. It just doesn't work. Half of it is okay. The rest of it spills out. It just doesn't work. So I am sometimes, it's like, I feel like it's my job to protect the authenticity and integrity of the work that I do, because I feel like every time I work, I represent mediumship. And that's important to me. So, but it's always an honor to share this space, and particularly this space. And I will say, helping parents heal changed everything for me. Before I started working with this organization, I would get some children, but I would freeze. I would get really nervous because I didn't want to get it wrong. And I would like lose the connection, or I would try to, you know, get it right. And as soon as my ego's involved, I want to get it right. I start getting it wrong. So I had to really do a lot of letting go and just go with it. And sometimes a grandma comes through to bring through a daughter or a son. You know, sometimes the person from high school that you knew that, you know, took their own life comes through and you're not even thinking of them. I don't know what the why, but I do know if I could be a spirit DJ all day and work, if it worked 100% of the time, I would do it, you know? But you could be like, yeah, I want to hear from my grandma Pat, and I'll get like your Uncle John, you know? So it's an interesting thing. And we do it together. You know, we really do it together. So before I start, I will get into connections. I just see if anyone had a question that I could answer. I don't want to go on too long. I can do that. But I do want to connect for some people. But I just want to know if anyone had a question that I can answer.
So please put any questions in the chat box if you have any. And I know that a lot of you just want to get started on the validations. So, but again, if you do have a question that you'd like to ask Drew, please do so. By the way, I just wanted to say that you're right. Maybe the Uncle John will come through instead of the grandmother. But, oh, Lindsay is asking, do you feel the kids now? I just wanted to say that a lot of times those are gatekeepers for your children who are actually going to come through soon after, or your Uncle John who's going to come through. So do you feel the kids now, Drew?
Oh, yeah. I always feel that power. Yeah. So how do you tell those who transition that we want to meet them? That's a really good question. I don't really tell them anything. I think the intent is the language they speak. When our intention is to give a reading and yours is to get a reading, I feel like there's definitely a power there. And that's where the bridge starts to open up. The thing we can't control within the bridge, traffic and the weather, you know? And what I mean by that is sometimes it doesn't matter. In my experience, is if they passed 2 weeks ago, it doesn't matter as far as a connection, but the emotional state and the receptivity that I can display and convey can change based on emotions, based on, it could be me, you know, there's a lot of things that can go into it. But most of the time, as long as somebody's not like, I've had people, like if I do a group and I have someone that's like, if this is real, say 777, like in their mind, all I get is like an energy fence over them. That's like, don't come to me. Don't come to me. Don't come to me. It's so weird. So it's kind of like, and everyone says they're open, but I think, I can't always tell sometimes exactly why there's a great connection with this person or not with this person. I was born with the skills. Can a person learn them? Absolutely. Absolutely. I teach it quite often. I do a butterfly course. I do a lot of different courses long-term so that it can integrate into your life. You can develop these abilities. To what degree depends. Like, I don't know. I know that everybody, if you all were with me for a weekend, I could get everybody connecting with people on the other side. You'd get some validations and you'd be very surprised. However, you know, come Monday or Tuesday the next week, if you went out and started trying to read people, not everyone's maybe called or meant to do this professionally or do it in that capacity. Sometimes it's a learning experience just for us. I have a lot of that. So it's a really incredible thing. Good questions. But I was going to say that sometimes somebody books a reading for me from 5-6 months ago. They want to connect with their mom. And in the meantime, their brother passes and they come in, and 2 weeks ago was the funeral. Now, I don't know who they are, anything about them. When they come in, their brother comes through crystal clear. So it's my experience that there isn't some sort of healing kind of time or delay. However, for the living and for the receptivity, I do feel like there needs to be a certain alignment, if you will. And that could be timing. I've had a lot of people book on a very specific date and they're like so intent on it being a certain thing. And sometimes that works, sometimes it doesn't. I just feel like they're going to come through when they can give you the most meaningful, impactful message that they can. You know, that's been my experience. And I do feel like it, you know, it's hard because I want it. If I could give you all what you wanted, I would, I promise you, you know, and I feel like, maybe there's a reason that we only get limited to certain things, because otherwise we might do this too often, you know? So,
I'm all day doing this, right? I think important to understand too. I mean, I think that yes, because it is fun to talk to our loved ones on the other side, but they want us to be doing other things here, and they want us to be living our lives and thinking about them, but moving forward. There's another question from Bonnie that unfortunately you didn't see. Can people feel negative emotions like guilt or anger on the other side? Could you just let her know?
Sure. So spirits on the other side. Is there barking in my house?
Not in mine.
Sorry, I think my dog Hopper is like, hold on one sec. He is. He's crazy. Okay, he was. I was like, is that me or is somebody's dog here? So I would say that overwhelmingly, they know how we feel. Our emotions are how we navigate this life. We're not meant to logic through it, right? I mean, we use our logic, but it's really all about understanding, feeling, learning, unfortunately hurting, but getting through that on the other side. I can show you hundreds of people that have had horrible things happen, and then I could show you the pathways of healing, how much they've changed and helped other people and reignited their life in different ways. So I do feel that they do feel the guilt. They do understand where we are emotionally. Like there's a difference in a feeling of a reading for someone where it's been a year or two and where it's been 5 or 10, depending on where that person's at though, and what kind of dynamic it's in. So it's a really interesting feeling. I do feel that. And also their language changes with you. You know, they will speak to you one way for a period of time and then you might stop getting them that way. And that's purposeful because otherwise you might, you know, your healing might stagnate. And they want us, like Elizabeth said, like they really want us to understand that their home we're visiting. It's not the other way around, you know, and that's a very difficult concept, especially with children. So I do understand that. And as much as I'm sorry for all of you having the losses you've had to be here, HPH is such a wonderful organization. Thank God for it, because I've seen it help and save a lot of people, you know. So with all that said, I'm going to start. So as I connect, I am aware of a younger male. I'm aware of two though. Hang on a sec. So I have a younger male here who I feel like I need to talk about. Either the name is Mark or Mike is what I get. And I also get, I don't know if somebody's unmuted, but there's something really like, I have these headphones on. It's really, can you guys just make sure you're muted? And when I promise, if it's for you, just kind of raise your hand or I'll try to, my most important job is to get the right person to the right person. Otherwise it's going to be like a, yeah, kind of, sort of, no. Right. And the best groups that I do are the groups that are here to help and here, they're here to, like you're either lending to the group or you're taking from it. So whoever's getting connected with, please be part of the group and be really present. It really does help with the connections, believe it or not. So I do feel like I need to reference this name, Mark. And I feel like, I also feel like this person unfortunately feels to me that they would have been accountable or taken their own life. Does someone understand that? And I feel like, I don't know why, but they keep showing me brown hair, brown eyes.
Okay. So Lindsay is saying my son Mike passed by suicide. So this might be the right person. Does that sound right to you?
Let's try. So Lindsay, can I hear your voice?
So Lindsay, let's go ahead and find you
Lindsay.
And unmute you.
I see her.
Okay. So
I think you're unmuted, Lindsay. Can you just say hello?
Okay. Yes. Hello. Okay. Thank you.
So Lindsay, would it make sense that your son was either just about or younger than 20?
No.
How old was he?
35.
Okay. So I could be wrong on the age maybe, but let me just stay with this for a second. Sorry, my dog is going bananas behind me. I know you can't hear it, but so also, would you understand there's two siblings or he's one of two?
There are two siblings.
Okay. And is it a brother and a sister?
two brothers.
Okay. Now, do you understand your, did, is his name Mark or Mike?
Mike.
Okay. So did Mike also have a child?
Yes.
Okay. Did he have a son?
Yes.
Okay. There might be two, but I'm aware of one. Okay. So, and also, is he the middle child?
Yes.
Okay. He keeps showing me like he's in the middle, like yes. Monkey in the middle, like Mikey in the middle. I have to tell you. And also, he just makes me feel like he's the handsome one.
Oh my gosh. Yes.
And like, there's a very charming air to him, where you might not understand how he was feeling what he was feeling, or it wouldn't be so evident, I guess. But also, he just makes me feel like, so I know that there were relationship issues, correct?
Yes.
Okay. He just keeps making me feel like there's this push pull, and I don't know why, but so is it true his son's about 9?
A little older.
Okay. Was he 9 when he passed or no?
He was.
Okay. So, so sometimes, like, again, the content I get right, but they'll always give it to me right. But the context I put it in can be a little bit skewed. So just work with me on that. And mm-hmm. I'll know if I don't want to make things fit.
No.
So also with him, he just keeps making me feel like, things came very easy to him, but when they got hard, it was like, there's a stubbornness with him in some ways, but also a very, it's like in some ways he just makes me feel like emotionally he didn't grow up. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
Okay. And also there must have been like a drinking or drugging issue.
Both.
Okay.
Self-medication.
Got it. Only because he just makes me feel like it was good until it wasn't. Like he could manage things until he couldn't. And I got to tell you, there's a lot of love here for you. And also, so does he have 2 children or 1?
He has a biological son and 2 stepsons.
Okay. So I'm aware of, but hold on. So after he passed, was there a girl born in the family?
No.
I'm just really aware of it. So I don't know why I keep getting this, but I don't mean to like stick on this. So either there was a little girl that was very special to him living and very special, almost like feels like his, or after he passed, someone had a little girl that he keeps referencing. And I mean, unless someone's pregnant, a little girl's coming, but it feels like this is somebody that's living. Does that make sense to you, or you're not sure? And if you're not sure, I'm okay with that. I just need to get it out of my
head. Yeah, I'm not really sure.
Okay. And so I don't fully understand this, but so who's James? Is that his brother?
No.
So who would be the one syllable J name, like James or John or Jay?
His brother's Jay.
That's it. Okay. So that's close enough. James to Jay. Okay. Yeah. So, I've never read for you. I've never met you, right? So no. I only want to say that so that people witnessing like understand. I have no idea what I'm getting until I'm getting it. Because in order to do this improv style and you in it with me, it needs to be like that. And if I get it a little bit wrong, like if I say James and their name's Jay, please help me out a little bit. Okay. I have to say too, and also, is there like a, hold on. So is there a Ryan or a Brian?
Not close.
So is that a yes?
Yes.
Okay. Who is that? Who is that? Who is the Ryan? Ryan or the Brian? But I want to say Ryan. Who's the Ryan to you or to him?
Ryan would have been a family member through his marriage.
Okay. I don't know why I'm aware of this, but I feel like there's other things that I can get to, but let me just stay with this. So, and also I don't know, Mike keeps making me feel like there's, I don't know what context to put this in, but he just keeps making me aware that there's some difficulties here, or he had a difficult conversation before he left with Dad. Do you understand that?
So his, no.
Are you still with his dad, or is
No, his father passed away.
Got it. Okay, don't say anything else. Don't say anything else.
Okay.
Because he kept bringing up dad and I wasn't sure where to put it.
Yeah.
So I messed it up. So I'm okay with that if he's on the other side. Do you also understand, though, that there's like addiction issues in the family? Yes.
Yes.
Or alcoholism. But okay. So, and there's also this older male that has blue eyes. Is that your husband? Is that his dad or is that somebody older?
His stepdad.
Okay. Who passed?
No, his stepdad's still here.
Okay. So maybe he's trying to distinguish between the two. I'm sorry. Okay. So mm-hmm. I got to tell you, it's interesting because he makes me feel like you really understood him.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean? Very There's a real, real strong bond here with you. And it's like more than anyone, you understood him and got him. And it hurts him that he hurt you. All right. And I need you to know that. And look, if it doesn't help or it doesn't heal, it's probably not real and I don't get it. So I know it might make you emotional and that is not my intention, but I need to be an ambassador to spirit. And the one thing he keeps giving me is that, hold on. So I don't know, this must've been within the last 4 years or less, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And do you understand why he'd be showing me the month of June?
Yes.
Okay. Is it a birthday or a passing?
It's a birthday.
Okay. And also the September?
There is a birthday.
Okay. I don't know why he's showing me the months, but maybe he's just trying to get to as many people as he can. I don't know. But I will say the personality that he has would remind me of you. Do you understand that? There's a way that he speaks and there's this banter that I feel like you guys would have had. He just makes me feel like you were everything for him. And he doesn't want you to feel that you let him down. Okay? It's really, really important. Like he just makes me it's very important that you understand for him. I hate to say this. It's like, he just makes me feel like nothing was going to stop this.
I believe that.
Okay. And I've, and like, I just need you to know that as much as he is connected to the emotional distress and dropping that pebble in the pond that's affected everybody with the negativity and the hurt, he's aware of that. But as far as him finding any kind of healing or balance, I feel like he wasn't going to find that in the living. And he just needs you to know that. Okay. And also, so who's like the D name, like a Devin or a Dylan? Who's that? Do you understand this? If it's David, I'm okay with that, but it's like a D.
Drew.
Is that his son's name?
His little brother.
Okay. Sorry. I never get my own name. I can't. I don't know why. All right. So, okay. Fair enough. So he named both his brothers then. True.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So also, I just have to say, he just keeps making me feel like he needs you to know that he's okay. And he's with you every step of the way and that you have to keep connecting and helping other people, but to help yourself.
Yes.
Okay. And I know that in some level, you're very proactive or active in the healing process or the connectivity process with other moms or other dads, but other people. Do you understand that?
Correct. Yes, very
and,
much.
He just makes me feel like there's a lot to be said. And also you must write a lot. So do you write to him?
No.
Okay. So hold on. Someone else, there's something else that keeps coming up with this little girl. So let me just, so does this make sense to anyone else? And I don't mean to put you off, Lindsay.
That's okay.
I don't want you to feel that anything I'm saying is not for you, but I feel like there's some shift now that I'm aware of and I'm not sure how to go about it. So just hang with me a sec. So Lindsay, do you also understand your dad passed too, correct?
Correct.
Okay. So I just need you to know that like him and your son are together. And also as much as you might have resentments with his biological dad, I feel like, does it make sense that like, I just need to make sure that this is right. His stepdad might have been really compassionate and there for him, but was there like a disconnect with him and his stepdad?
Yes.
Okay. I don't mean to harp on it. I just need
That's
to,
okay.
Like he kept giving me this thing going forward. And when it comes forward, it's usually in the living. He's just like apologetic for that because like you needed someone solid. And also he just makes me feel like, he just doesn't want anyone else to suffer from what he's done, especially you, but he just wants his brothers to be able to live a full life. And also he doesn't want you to be pissed at his ex. Okay. Do you understand that?
Yes. That's a tough one.
I know. So, because he just makes me feel like his little one will always feel that.
I'm never outwardly pissed in front of.
I got it. But I'm just saying, I think this is the hardest stuff that needs to be peeled back. And it's the stuff that we want to do the least is the hell stuff that will help us the most.
Right.
So, because the word resentment is literally Latin for refeel. That's all it is to refeel something that triggers something in us. And he just keeps making me aware that he needs you to let him be responsible for his actions, his behaviors, what he said and what he didn't do, because he just keeps making me feel like he kept dropping the ball. And that has to be on him. It can't be on her. And even if she overreacted and made it really difficult, particularly with custody or money, he just makes me feel like it's just important that he just wants you to be able to honor, I guess, her in a way that you can. That's all. Okay. It doesn't have to be any more than that. All right. And one other thing, I don't know who this is. So your dad smoked?
Oh, years ago. Okay. His dad smoked.
Okay. I just keep getting this man who's like smoking cigarette after cigarette next to me.
That's probably his dad.
Did you call him Pop?
No.
Okay. I keep getting this with Pop or Pops. One other thing. Did your mom also pass?
Yes.
Okay. So you got a lot of people coming through. I just also need to say, hold on. So is she Kathy?
No.
So who would be Catherine or Kathy?
He has an Aunt Kathy.
Who passed?
No, she's still living.
This is past. So maybe I'm wrong on that. But is it your mom's sister or your dad's?
No. No, Kathy.
You just said it's an aunt, right?
Yes,
he has. Oh, your dad's aunt or your...
No, my son's aunt.
Right.
Mikey's aunt.
So, Kathy. Okay. Right. Is she connected through your dad or your mom?
Through his dad.
His dad. Okay, got it. Oh, I got it. So, hold on. One other thing. I just keep getting that... I'm trying to like, I thought I was going to someone else. Now it's circling right back to you. I need to say this in a way that I've said this to other people, but I feel like it keeps coming back to the writing. Like it's really important the ritual in spiritual can be really rewarding. And I keep getting that he's asking that you, because you've done a lot of healing, like you've done a lot of work. And he's just really grateful that you have. And he's saying to, like, just take the time to write one more letter or one letter. And I don't care what you say in it. It could be angry. It could be like whatever it needs to be to put a pinhole in the balloon that's remaining. He just keeps giving me that just know that he'll sit with you and you burn it. So it goes into the ether. And air is the symbol of spirit because we can't see it. But he just keeps making me feel like.
I just thought of something. I did write in counseling. She had me write lots of different.
So things. You were, but this is about something new, even though you did, because I kept saying you must write a lot. So that must've been helpful in some ways, because it is emotionally a release, but he keeps making me feel like I need to outline this pen. Like I can't get the pen, stop writing. So do it again, just you and him, and know that he'll sit with you. And also just be careful not to have to fix everybody. You got to take care of you. It's important because you can't protect everyone from other people and their actions. Okay.
Yes.
I got to tell you, he just doesn't want to go. He loves you. Absolutely adores you. And you just need to know that this is not on you. It's not on you. Not on you. It's on him.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. One other thing. Hold on. Oh my God. So do you, I would be surprised if this isn't for someone else, but I'm going to try it with you. Do you understand the black and white cat on the other side or living?
That I'm not sure.
Okay. So I'm going to let you go.
Okay.
And only because I'm getting other things that don't feel coordinated.
Okay.
But thank you so Lindsay. Much. And yeah, please again, know that he's home. We're visiting and he's with you every step of the way.
That is beautiful. And Lindsay, please do send me a validation if you can. That would be so wonderful for the newsletter. I put my email in the chat box. And if you could do that with a picture of Mike, that would be so wonderful, both for all of the parents here, but also for Drew. Go ahead, Drew. I'm sorry.
No, that's okay. Thank you. Okay. So I know I still have to go back a little bit. So is there someone, I saw someone pop up with something while I was doing this where there's somebody, this little girl, I don't know if this little girl is coming through for somebody here or if they were connected to the person that I just had, but did somebody say, could somebody take that thing about the younger girl that passed connected to the male? Or that the girl was born right after him? Does anyone understand that? Maybe I'm going backwards and it's not going to work.
Carol Marie said that she could take everything, even the baby girl born afterwards.
Okay, good.
Oh, got it. Okay. So I'll just leave you with that, Carol Marie. Thank you. Because it did feel like at one point that it was like maybe I had two people going on at once. I can't always feel that, but I did feel like when she was saying no to some things, I was like, how could that be kind of thing? And that's when I kind of trust that they were trying to get to someone else too. All right. So let me just go a little bit further here. And if everyone could just take a deep breath for me, not that I can hear you, but I know. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. I always joke, like I don't take myself that seriously, but I take what I do very seriously. But sometimes you have to mix it up a little bit. Otherwise, it can be quite intense, right? So I have another male here, a younger male, and I feel that I need to go, this is a little bit different. This feels like there was a medical condition and there was either a passing while they were in surgery or the surgery couldn't be done in time, but something in relation to a surgery or a medical procedure, if you will, this I want to say boy or this younger male would have passed. And I feel like I need to go with the name that sounds to me like Jonathan or John. I don't know if that's his name or somebody connected to him, but does somebody understand this?
Let us know in the chat box if you do identify.
Yeah, and if the name's throwing you off, I'll go a little bit further. This feels to me very much like an ongoing medical condition. Like, I don't know if it's a cancerous condition or a like something I wouldn't be aware of, but like it feels blood related to me. That's how it feels to me. Does anyone understand this? And just think outside the box, even if it's connected to you or connected to somebody you may know, but I need to stay with this. And I also, I know that your mom would have also been passed. So Patty, and then someone else and. Yeah. So Patty, does that make sense for you? Has your mom also passed? I don't know where you are.
Let's see. So Patty, could you just answer in the chat box? My mom hasn't, but his mom has. So this is
okay.
The cousin who has cancer, but his name is not John, she's saying.
But can anyone understand that with the name of John?
Wait, yes, Jane is saying, my son is John. He had cancer, but did not pass from cancer. My mom passed.
So your son is living?
No, he had cancer, but did not pass from cancer. Did he pass then, Jane?
Okay, so Regina, can I have you on for a sec? Can I just hear your voice? It helps me sort through it. And if it's not for you, I apologize to get you up here and kind of have to kind of softly let you down if it's not, but I can't control that. But I just want to make sure, but it feels like I need to come to you. So hey, I just want to see.
Hi, Drew.
Hey.
Hi.
Where are you? There you are. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm okay. So you understand. But your son did pass.
Yes.
And he did have a cancerous condition. Did he have a cancerous condition when he was like significantly younger?
No, my son passed, but my husband, who is also John, who's here, is suffering from a cancer.
Okay. So would your son and your and his whose mom
and my
passed?
Mother has passed.
Okay, got it. So do you understand the Patty?
Patty.
Yeah. The Pat or the P name? Just say no. I could, no. If you have to think about it too much, no. I don't want to try to force. Okay. Stay with me a sec. So like, I'd rather be real than be right. I don't mind getting certain things wrong. But I just need to kind of go in here a little bit. So would you understand with your son, he would have passed unexpectedly?
Yes. Very.
Okay. And do you understand also that, your husband is he still undergoing treatment?
Yes, he is.
Okay. Okay. And do you understand? I don't know why this is so. What's with the 11s? Do you understand that?
I see 11-11.
Okay, perfect.
Past month all the time. Yes.
Perfect. And do you guys have two dogs or two dogs that passed?
Yes, two dogs that passed.
Okay.
Yes.
And I don't know if one's like kind of a golden retriever, but it feels like that to me.
Yes.
Right? Okay. And also that I keep getting this over and over that it's interesting. So I don't fully understand. So can I ask, are you Italian?
No, no.
Okay. Are you like Greek or Jewish?
No, Spanish.
Okay, I'll take it.
German.
I hate to say that, but like I will get different like ethnicities that feel similar to my that Italian side of mine. So
yes.
I hope that makes sense. Okay.
Yes, it does.
And also that, hold on. So I just want to make sure I got this right. So would you also understand that, I don't fully understand this. I just want to make sure I'm right on this. Do you understand that your son would also take accountability for passing?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm really sorry for your loss, because he just makes me feel like I don't want to talk about it, but I got to say this, like he won't give me a lot of details. So you must have gotten, he keeps telling me there's at least two good readings you've had.
Yes.
True. Okay.
Yes.
And he just keeps making me, he's funny. He's like third time's a charm. He also makes me feel like he just needs you not to worry so much. He just keeps making me feel like there's so much worry and anxiety. And obviously that makes sense with, now, also, hold on. So I don't fully understand this. So does somebody have like a weird nickname that had to do with Red?
Red.
Yeah, like Big Red, or I don't understand what I'm getting, but I know I keep getting this like reference to it. You don't understand that? So would you understand? I know this is going to sound a little bit maybe batshit, but.
It's okay.
Is there somebody in the family that's born and they have like red hair? And it's like odd?
No, not that I know of.
Okay. So I'm going to leave that alone. I don't know why I'm getting that. But I keep getting this thing about a nickname that has to do with red. And at first I thought it was like red hair on a dog. And then I kept seeing it on a person. So I wasn't exactly sure. So also, so you must have been, so you're very stubborn, correct?
Yes.
Okay. I'm only saying that because not to like, it's never a judgment. It's like I get over exaggerated impressions. So I'm not laughing at you. I'm with you. I promise you.
I admit
you and
it.
Me both. But also your mom is the same way.
Yes.
True. Okay. Yes. Because she makes me feel like she is here. She is really strong. She is exactly like you or very much like you. And also, I don't know, but you must have like a significant, either a recipe book or there's something shared here about that. Do you understand that? Like there's a love for the kitchen or cooking or certain recipes.
My son and I used to always cook together.
Perfect.
And he had a recipe book.
God, okay, perfect. Oh, so you have his recipe book?
His things he would write down, yes.
I love it. I love it. And also, I don't know why, but there's like a very significant thing here about, I keep seeing a pot with like stew or soup. And it's like, I see big chunks of potatoes. So I don't know exactly what that is, and I'm no cook. Oh, but yes. I keep feeling like it's a very specific, like either family recipe or something he was like either working on. I don't really follow. But, and hold on. So do you understand too that, I don't fully understand this. I'm going to go with this a little bit. Do you understand that he had like quite a bit of social anxiety?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, he did.
There's this almost feeling of like I have to communicate with him a very specific way, or he's communicating with me a very specific way. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Okay. It's like he has to learn his way. He has to receive his way. Otherwise, yep. It's like, I don't know. It's like all fucking out here. I don't know.
It's all over the place.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes. And it's like, but you were very good at outlining how you were very helpful in helping him manage his like focus, but also his direction. Do you understand that?
Okay. I try.
Okay. But I got to say this in a big way because he makes me feel like in some ways, like it's like, I don't know if it's that he's trying to show me that he didn't know how to grow up, but he's making me feel like you were like his everything, and that he makes me feel like you just need to know that he wouldn't have made it that far without you. And he just kept making me, he just makes me feel like the world was very overwhelming to him.
Thank you. Yes, yeah. It was.
Do you understand that? Thank There's just you. This super much. Sensitivity with him that is like, very unique and very, like, you really have to know him to know him.
Yes.
You know, like really in a big way, like he's, you know, and once you know him, you can't help but love him. And it's like, he just got very frustrated with him. And he just makes me feel like he didn't know how to articulate that in a way. And he was afraid that he was always going to feel, like badly or or inept or out, like left out. That's the feeling yes. I have. Do you understand that?
Yes, I do.
And he always felt very connected in the family. He just makes me feel like he didn't know how to go about the world. And he just needs you to know that he's okay. And I got to say, it's so funny because he makes me feel like, so did your mom used to dance? Because
yeah.
He's dancing with her.
He's
showing me that he would dance with her, like holding hands and doing like a dance. And it's like,
when he was little.
Got it.
Yeah.
So just know that he's trying to show you that the innocence is back. Okay. Oh,
that's
it's like
wonderful.
In a big way. Yeah. And also it's so funny because he makes me feel like he has such a unique style with everything, even music.
He was like
an adult. When he was like a kid with music.
Yes.
You understand that?
He was a music producer.
Oh, so okay.
He made music.
Got it. I understand. Okay. And that was really his language. Right. Okay. Got it. Because he kept making me feel like he could do things as a kid with music, or even the music he was drawn to was like background music you would hear in a movie or classic. Yes. Like it was different. It wasn't like, I'm going to go listen to The Clash. It was like, there's that too, but there's this whole other element that like yes. Music that I wouldn't have paid attention to was very important to him. It gave theme and it gave life and it gave love. And it was like this real passion. And also, I don't understand. He must've played piano.
Yes, he did.
Okay. And also he tried singing, but he tells me he's not so good.
I thought he was good.
I'm sure you did.
I did. But
so I just have to say, I just keep getting also that, I don't understand this. Who's Bob or Robert?
There's a couple, but there's one.
It's like I'm saying hi to the Bob or Rob.
It could be a friend of his.
Okay. It would have to be connected to him more than you, or okay. It would have to be a relative. Okay. But I have to say also, I don't fully understand this, but so your husband's father passed, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Was he the one in the Navy?
Yes, he is.
Okay.
Yes.
He keeps showing me the flag that he has and the naval stuff.
Yes.
Or naval cross or the blue. And he just needs you to know that he's connected with everybody. He'll always be your boy. He'll always be his mom. And he doesn't want you to feel that you could have done anything differently. And he's glad that you didn't. And I got to say that he's making music on the other side and he's dancing. He's just making this, like, he just makes me feel like he's living the life that he wanted to live on earth on the other side. And it's not to highlight that he's doing it without you. It's to let you know as his mom that he is at peace and he is okay. And he's just there every step of the way, also with John.
Thank you, Drew. Okay?
Yeah. And I don't know why he keeps showing me the significance of October.
That's when he passed, and okay. He passed the day before my husband's birthday. So
okay. They're both in October. So he just doesn't want to ruin the birthday anymore.
Okay.
Okay, like he doesn't want it to be a down thing. He just needs you to know for him, it's a celebration of like a rebirth. And it might not be the way that you expect, but he's also telling you that some people think he might not belong there, but he's with everyone else. Okay?
Okay.
I'll leave you with that. Yeah, he does.
On the good side.
Regina, thank you so much. I'll leave you with that.
Thank you, Drew.
And I really am sorry for your loss, but I'm glad we're able to share this space. So thank you.
Yes, thank you. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
Regina, I am so glad that you got that. And so many people are identifying with Jonathan and feeling like he's so similar to their own sons and feeling like they're very grateful that they were able to be at this reading to be able to hear more from their own son. I just want to say, in case anybody doesn't realize this, they're all friends and they're all working together to get the maximum number of messages through. And so, obviously, Jonathan is friends with all of these kids, and it's beautiful to hear. This has been so wonderful. Kathy was saying that a lot of people are asking how to contact you now that your website is down. Do you have any good contact information that we
can? Yeah, so everything will be up within a day or two, and we do have some inquiries about doing live readings out in over the summer at the conference. And also if you wanted to book via Zoom or phone, I'm going to put the website in here. If you just put your email in, and when you email us, just say that you're part of HPH. You don't have to say that if you don't want to. Sometimes people don't want to because they want it to be more evidential so that I don't know anything about you. I'm okay with that. But I'll put my website, which you can subscribe to, or just send an email to info@mediumdrew.com. And again, I know it's a little weird having an under construction website. I've had a website for like 12 years, and all of a sudden the one that I'm doing now is under construction. It's like this close to being live. We have a glitch. So please just email us or go and subscribe and just say, I'm looking for a reading either at the HPH conference or, you're looking for a reading via Zoom before then or via Zoom. So, but thank you all so much. And thank you, Elizabeth and Kathy, for having me. It's always an honor and privilege. And I just want to say that, the access to within HPH is only as good as the access that you utilize. I hope you guys connect with each other and you get connected with groups and therapy and all the other outside help. Mediumship is amazing. But sometimes it's just, it's the skeleton key to the door that you need at that time. Sometimes you have to kind of walk into the house and kind of take care of you in other ways too. And I will say that, there is an echelon of reading difference in people that are doing the work on themselves, as opposed to kind of just, it's this is the most difficult thing that anyone could go through, period. You know, to be able to have, and I've worked with people that don't want to be here anymore themselves. So my heart goes out to you, but please use the people that are in this similar situation. And, you know, it's very brave to ask for help, you know, and if you isolate and try to do it alone, it can be a habit that you can't break, you know, so please don't do it alone if you don't have to. That's all. Thank you so much for having me.
And just to let everyone know, we do have caring listeners that are all volunteer parents. And now we have 12 languages spoken because we just had a Swedish caring listener come on board. And so we have caring listeners around the world, but also here in the States and in Canada and all these other places that were present. So if you are feeling like you need to speak to someone, they are just an ear to listen and they have gone through this. You've gone down the healing path a little bit further and they reach a hand back to others to help them forward. Being a caring listener is something that we all adore. We love being called. We love being able to help others. So please don't hesitate to do so. They're on our website as well. And again, our website is www.helpingparentsheal.org. And before we leave, we want to just allow everyone to unmute and say thank you and good evening. So if you'd like to do so, go ahead.
And thank you, Drew. That was
thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Drew.
Thanks so much.
Thanks, Drew.
Thanks, Kathy. Bye-bye.
Thank you.